Once you've got a Facebook page set up, it's important to think about adding additional people who can be the administrator for that page. That's to cover any issues around absenteeism, somebody moving on from an organization. To ensure continuity, you're able to access the page. Plus, it also shares the burden. Here's how it's done. So this is my Facebook page, and I can go to settings. And then here on the left-hand side, click on page roles. And there's the option assign a new page role, or you could jump straight to existing page roles. So here you type in a name or email address, and you've got two options. You've got the lower level option, which is editor. So they can add content and look at the material on there, but they can't add or remove people as admins. Or you can go for moderator, an even lower level, so they're unable to view the statistics about the page and that sort of thing. Now let's say an editor, and then you search for somebody who's a friend, ideally. That makes it easier to add them straight away. If you don't have their, you're not a friend on Facebook, you can also search by email address. So I'm going to add Peter as an editor, and I obviously need to confirm my password to make sure it goes through. And the person that you've invited will get their invitation through, and they can confirm that. They'll get a message, like a notification. And now you can see, there we go, somebody else. With the options available to you, if you go admin, and it would be useful to have at least one other administrator available, make sure that they know that they've got full access rights, therefore they could, I suppose if they fell out with you, they could remove you as the original admin of the page. But barring that, it's a simple way to make sure that whoever's posting as the page has proper access to it and can be part of the team. Because anyone who's not an admin of the page, if they post to it, it will just go down to the side. And just to show you a quick example here, if somebody is an admin, it says published by that particular person. This is only visible to the admins or whatever, but somebody else here has published this article. So as an admin, you can tell who it is that's actually posted the content. So again, a very useful feature.